Hello, I'm Mike. Coming up, I try to vibe code a database and payments into the app I built last week. We also look at vibe coding safely. And, well, if you haven't heard it already, Stephen Bartlett has said what we're all feeling.
I heard vibe coding, I heard AI agent. I was like, I will give it a shot. So Someone like me with absolutely no coding skills was able to build a website, build in Stripe, take payment, integrate AI into my website, add Google login to the front of my website, and do it within minutes.
Yes, if you're a regular viewer of the channel, you'll be well aware of this, and I recommend you listen to the full AI agents debate on Diary of a CEO, which I'll link up down below. And by the way, on that note, around 75% of you who watch this video are not already subscribed to my channel, so please go ahead and do that. Let's dive in. And we're going to get started with Manus. Manus is a really cool AI agent, and it just got the ability to see things and work with images. Now, I'm a fan of really loud, crazy shirts like this, and I'd kind of like to look at how I will look wearing those shirts. Now, on my desktop, I've got a picture of me speaking at a recent event. That looks good. Show me how this person would look in some of the shirts available here. And then just here, we'll paste in the link to that store. So you can see already it's browsing the website here with the shirts, and you can see in its computer, it's looking at that website. I can click here to open Manus's computer, and we can actually see in real time it is indeed browsing that website and working, creating more images. While Manus is busy working away, I'm going to upload another file. And this time I've got a screenshot of the game I vibe coded earlier this week called Super Snake, Rainbow Colored Snakes, but I'd like to reskin it with some new ideas. I'm building a 2D Super Snake game with rainbow snakes. One is a human player, the other is AI. I'd like to create different skin upgrades based on a magic and wizard theme, generate 5 snake skins, 10 different food items, and 3 background layers, all in a consistent style based on this screenshot of the game. And you'll see here it's picked up the Super Snake game, and it says I'll help you generate the game assets for your game, including the 5 skins, 10 food items, and background layers. So it's analyzing that screenshot, and it's going to get to work. Again, we'll return to this task a little bit later as Manus works away. Talking about Super Snake, I vibe coded this game using Hosting Horizons earlier this week. It's the human versus AI, and I'm encouraging you to vibe code your own game that people can play online. There is a $1,000 cash prize, kindly sponsored and paid by Hostinger, also runner-up prizes of some free hosting on Hostinger. So what are you waiting for? Click the link down below, enter the contest. Now, there have already been some fantastic entries. Imran, I've got to say, you've done something absolutely brilliant here. I'm loving playing this game and trying to avoid all the skulls and things I shouldn't be collecting. And I can see as I go along, it's gradually getting faster and faster, which is kind of a little bit of a worry because I need to improve my hand-mouse coordination. I can't get my mouse there in fast enough. It's that nearly, oh, there you go. Game over with a high score of 70. Well done, Imran, for that contribution. And go and vibe code your own game and submit it using the link down below for a chance to win $1,000 or some free hosting from Hostinger. Oh, and as I speak, more images and designs are being generated. This one's quite cool. I can actually go ahead and download it, upload it to Hostinger Horizons, and simply prompt, update my snakes in the Super Snake game to look more like this. And the food should also look like the screenshot. This is all using a screenshot that was generated by my AI agent. And look at this, Hostinger is going straight to work. It says it will redesign the player in AI. Now we can go ahead and retest the game. And look at this, we've definitely got a different looking Super Snake game based on the new design that I uploaded. And now it looks like this is just about wrapping up. It says all images have been generated and delivered to the user. Manus has completed the task. Let's have a look. There's one image and there's another image. I mean, it's slightly adjusted how I look, but it's interesting. I can get an idea how I might look in those t-shirts. Next up, Amjad Massad, who is the CEO of Replit, the vibe coding tool, has said vibe coding is flooding the internet with vulnerabilities. So novices in Cursor and Windsurf and other tools can expose their API keys. That's why they've introduced vibe coding safely. Now, yes, this is really relevant because if we don't know what we're doing and we get the AI to do everything, we could be creating an app with serious security holes. And this is where AI coding apps such as Replit are introducing safe vibe coding. But there's also a new release from CodeRabbit, which does code review and looks for bugs instantly. Now it's all set up. I've got my Comment Genie repo loaded in Cursor. We'll go to extensions and type in CodeRabbit. Install. Okay, now CodeRabbit is set. I've got one file from my front end and two files from the Python backend. I'm going to ask CodeRabbit to review these uncommitted changes to my GitHub, and it will start setting up and analyzing the changes to the files. It's going to look at everything for really high safety standards. Okay, and you can see already in the main app, four potential issues flagging up for me. And these are really cool. It's telling me there's incorrect handling of credentials expiry, API comments endpoint will raise name error, it's given me secret key is weak and predictable, cookie marked as secure equals false, you should reconsider in production, and there's a missing default for the grok model that may break reply generation. This is awesome. It's found five errors with my app just with the click of one single mouse button. I really like the idea of CodeRabbit, and if it's going to make us safer vibe coders, this is a tool I recommend you install and try out for the 14-day free trial and let me know how you get on. The link is down below. So vibe code safely, my friends, and if you like what you see, throw a like and subscribe as I do these videos weekly. Now you'll see here, if I click one of the errors, it opens the file, jumps straight to the point, gives me the suggested change, and I can just tick to make that change to my code. The same with this error. Yep, it spotted something there. It gives me an idea to update it, make it safer, and there it is. Okay, last week on the channel, you might have seen that I built a micro SaaS called PimpMyThumb.com using the Windsurf AI coding editor. Well, it was a roaring success. Yes, you did blow up my OpenAI account, and if I go to my Amazon S3 bucket, 6,950 of you used PimpMyThumb.com in the last week. Now, obviously, those kind of costs and that kind of usage is not sustainable for me long term, but I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. Now it's time for me to try and vibe code a database and payment gateway to this, and let's see if we can do it before the end of this video. A quick reminder, this is how it works. You go to any YouTube video, you copy the link addressed, go to Pimp My Thumb, paste it in, and generate a new thumbnail. It will be a better version of that thumbnail. Yes, insane update. I quite like that. Before and after. Before, after. Really cool app. Now let's get the database and payment gateway integrated. And here's some news this week. Windsurf created their own AI models for coding. So inside Windsurf Wave 9, which I paid for last week, you've now got these models, SWE1 Lite for free, and also for a limited time to paid members, SWE1, which apparently is the same as Claude 3.7 Sonnet. So let's code my app using that model. Now, before I do anything, I'm going to configure an MCP server. I'll go to the plugin store, and this time I'll scroll down and I'll look for Superbase. Now, as I click install, it's asking me for a Superbase access token. First, I'll create a new Superbase called Pimp My Thumb. While that's setting up, we'll click this link here and generate a token for Windsurf. That worked, it's now enabled. Okay, with Superbase MCP server connected, let's create a database for my app. Connect this app to the Pimp My Thumb Superbase database and help me set up Superbase Auth so that all my users need to log in using Google before they can generate their first pimped up thumbnail. Okay, now it's done. It's telling me to set up Superbase and configure my .env file. Before we start this, I need to go and enable Google as a login for my app inside Superbase. Now I need to create a project called Pimp My Thumb in Google Cloud. Go to the consent screen. Oh, finally, dark mode is available. Yes, please. Okay, with that updated, let's get started. And we'll call the app Pimp My Thumb. It's going to be an external app. We'll agree and continue. Create an OAuth client called Pimp My Thumb. We'll just paste in my Superbase URL. And for the redirect, this comes from Superbase. Now under data access, we add some scopes and some very simple ones, just the user email, info, and their open ID. Save over here in Superbase, and now we have Google login enabled. Okay, MCP is now working with my Superbase database. Okay, this is looking good. It's logging me in with my Google account, giving me a logout option, giving me Pimp My Thumb. When I log out, it's taking me to a sort of broken sign in with Google button. We can fix that. And I can't get back to the app without logging in. I'm going to change that functionality a bit. Okay, instead of having /login page, what I'd like to do is have the index page open to all, but when you click the generate thumbnail button, it pops up and asks you to log in with Google. Let's watch this do its magic. As I'm logged out, let's try. Oh yes, sign in with Google. Okay, this is not looking too good. Let's get it all fixed. The login pop-up box is transparent, so it's hard to read the text, so please fix that. Also, on the login with Google buttons, the actual Google logo is broken, so please find a better source for that. There we go. That's looking much better. This is working perfectly. Generate. Yes, it's generating the thumbnail for me as a logged in user. And boom, look at that. Try this. I like that, actually. That's really cool. Generated inside my account in a matter of seconds. So it really is that easy using Superbase Auth and a little bit of no code inside Windsurf to have a user log in to use your app. Next up, instead of the thumbnail generating there and then and the user having to keep the window open for the job to finish, I'd like to kind of update this app so that when they click generate, it goes to like a library associated with the user inside Superbase. And basically then they'll have a history of all their generations and stuff. And rather than having to wait for it to update, maybe the app can just periodically check ongoing jobs in the background or something like that, and keep updating, you know, when things are ready. What do you think about that, and how could that work? Let's do this. Let's set up the Superbase table structure in the PimpMyThumb database. We'll create the backend job tracking system, design the frontend UI, and then implement the real-time updates, please. Okay, you'll see it's listing my projects via MCP. It's found PimpMyThumb, and it's creating the tables here. First of all, it's listing. It can find users. And now it's actually creating a thumbnail jobs table. You see, and this is brilliant because the SQL is being executed for me, so I don't need to do anything here. While we wait for that to go, we'll see there's a users table, but now there's also a thumbnail jobs table. We've got ID, job ID, user ID to associate with, video ID, status, created at, completed at. All of this stuff is really good. It stores the prompt, any errors that come in. So really, we've got a comprehensive database storage here, and this is all done on automation, I might add. This is very cool. Pending. I love this. What a cool user experience. And this was with one prompt. Let's take a look at thumbnail jobs. And indeed, that thumbnail job that I started is here. We've got the original YouTube image. Okay, we can see it's processing. This is cool. It's updated the status. Okay, and look at this. It's completed. Yes, we can view the details. We can see the before here and the after over here, looking really cool. Okay, it seems this is working exceedingly well. Let's create another new thumbnail, generate, submitting, and there we go, in the library. Now we can see this job is processing, and there we go, it's completed. That looks really cool, and if I go into view the details, we can see the pimped up thumbnail versus the original. I'd like you to change the user account button in the top right on the index and library page, and I would like, instead of the links, I would like it to be simply the user photo and their name. And then when you hover over it, it drops down a menu with my library and log out. All right, I'm really liking what I've got here. And here's a pimped up thumbnail, a pimped up thumbnail with Sam Altman. That's the original here. And this is the one that my app has just created. Pretty cool, right? We can also click to view the video on YouTube and it will take us straight through to the YouTube video. I would like the user to have credits that show in the top right on their profile, and one credit allows them to generate one thumbnail. Okay, this is looking much better now, and I can go to my library, and yeah, the credits are showing there. I've got one credit. When a new user is created or they log in and get their new credit, there should be a nice confetti animation around the credits counter. Oh, this is taking ages. I think this update just wrecked half of my site. Okay, here's a good learning for you. Always back up as you're going to GitHub. I have got myself stuck in a loop where it keeps trying to fix index.html, index.html, and it goes round and round. So here's my confession. I've gone over to Cursor and switched on the O3 max mode. I'm really hoping it's going to go through and fix all of my problems. It does seem to be thinking pretty heavily, and I'm keeping both my fingers crossed because everything at this stage is messed up. And it's still going here. Well, that did a big fat nothing. So I'm now in ChatGPT 03 up here and having it rewrite index.html for me entirely. Hopefully, this will fix my app so it works again. As you can see, vibe coding doesn't always work out. And this is where you need to rescue yourself. We're in a much better place here. Something is working. I've got my login stuff back, a few console errors, but wow, that was close. I'm going to back this up to GitHub right now. Right, phew. I think I fixed all the errors when I nearly vibe code broke my website. Now it seems to be working. I've cleaned up the homepage. It looks very nice and clean. I've got this login and that will take me to my library where I can see all my pimped up thumbnails here. I can even go ahead and download one if I like. It's really easy. I can view the details of the original and the enhanced version of the thumbnail. And of course, I can click to log out and return to the home screen here. This took me longer than I'd admit, so I'll save Stripe integration for next week. PimpMyThumb.com. Go and try it right now. And by the way, if you comment down below the number 100 and then give me an upgrade, a bug fix, or something extra you'd like to see on Pimp My Thumb, I will throw 100 free credits into your account. Okay? So all you got to do is comment down below with the number 100, an upgrade, or a bug fix you'd like to see, and I will send you 100 free credits to go crazy on Pimp My Thumb with. Enjoy it. Thank you so much for watching. I always really enjoy doing these videos. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now. You should watch next. Thanks.